हेलो मैम।
यस टेल मी हु इज दैट। यस स्टूडेंट्स डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज। ओनली दिस ओनली 3 days वी हैव ऑनलाइन क्लासेस एंड फ्रॉम थर्सडे अगेन वी हैव ऑफलाइन क्लासेस। डोंट गो टू योर नेटिव बिकॉज यू एनी वे ऑनलाइन क्लासेस आर देर। वी कैन गो टू नेटिव। नो डोंट टेक दैट डिसीजन बिकॉज एनी टाइम वी मे कॉल टू कॉलेज। So in that mail, principal sir has clearly mentioned that lab should be conducted offline only. Okay. Yes, students. One second, let me open the PPT. Yes, students, is my screen is visible? Is the PPT is visible? The letter reports.
यस मैम, यस मैम, यस
Okay. Yes, students, we were discussing second module. In the second module, we have learned the practice of we have learned the how the report should be and what all the content should be there in the report. And when you take when any work is assigned, it may be I have taken it may be any software project or any business example we take. So these things we should follow. That is subtopic. So the subtopic, hypothesis and comparison. And we have seen what type of error the human will do. So these things also we have seen. And this is very important, students, how the organization of a report, how the report will be. So this is a conventional way and this is a decimal system. And here we have also seen in the document what is important, how important the introductory part and how important the conclusion part and the subdivision of the organization. As I took the example of our college only the principal cannot do all the activities of the organization. So work will be divided into the subcategory. So according to the hierarchical structure, the work will be
ನಿನ್ನಿಂದನೇ ಫೇಲ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ನಿನ್ನಿಂದನೇ ಆಗೋದು. ಯಾವಾಗ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದೆ?
Who's that? Rashmi?
I'm sorry.
So the organization, please students all don't disturb. So in the organization, the division is very much important. And when we were discussing about the software project also, they also explained the scenario in the why in the beginning only we have to divide the project. Why? Because in the number of the human resource are decided in the beginning only. So in between, if we decide to assign any work to any of the employees, then it will be difficult for faculty. It will feel like it will be like burden. In the beginning only if we decide, and if we decide some one more person extra person we need to divide the work, then we have to decide in the beginning only. All this we have seen in the last class. The format also we have seen the letter format and the memos, how to whom we give memo and the resume. When we are developing a resume, what are the things we have to remember? So when we create a resume, the background fact and the objective of the resume is very much important, and the constructing headings is very much important, students. Constructing headings. Here I took this sample. I think this you can see this is strength. Here I am mentioned here in the resume they are mentioning the strength of the person whose resume it is. So what are the synonym of strength? Can anybody tell synonym of strength? Respond. Yes. No answer.
Mom, strong.
Strong. So instead of strength, can I write here strong? Can I write here strong, students? Here I am in the resume. I am mentioning the strength of a person. This resume is Dinesh Kumar's resume. Here I have written Dinesh Kumar has mentioned his strength. So the similar word for the synonym of strength is the strong. So can I use the word strong here, or can I use the word hard here? Yes, no, I cannot use strong, hard. So whichever words are related, whichever words are suitable, only those words we have to use to create any document. So the personal details, so all these things we have seen in the last class. So, and one more thing, students, when I was discussing this second module, I told the next is how to face interview. So how to face interview, you all know that what type of questions, how we have to face the interview. So that in the last class only I told you that we'll do activity on that, so that when you feel that, when you experience that, it will be more good. Why? Because theory, you know, anyway, you know how to face the interview and what all the things we have to take care in the interview. It may be the physical appearance, the dressing style, and when you walk into the interview room, how you should be. All things theory part, you know. So practical demonstration, when we do it in the activity, only then you'll get a clear idea. So only for time being, now I am moving to third module. Yes, students, I am moving to third module. So again, after the when you come back to offline class, again we'll come back to the second module. Yes, students, can you see the Word document? Can't see the Word document?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Here in the third module or in the third unit, here what we are going to learn is group communication, group discussion, and the organizational group discussion, and how the group discussion is a part of selection. Yes, you know, no, when committee come for, when any company or come for recruitment or for placement, then first the, maybe if the preliminary stage is this aptitude test. Once you clear aptitude test, then they may keep the technical interview or the technical test. So after clearing technical test, they may organize some group discussion. It depends on the company. Few companies will give importance to group discussion, and few companies will not conduct any group discussion. So when they conduct group discussion, why? What is the reason? Why the company has organized the why the company has selected, or why the company has kept this selection group discussion as a selection group discussion in the selection process? And when the company is keeping this GD in the selection process, how as a as an interviewer or as a member of a group discussion, how we have to behave? What are the instructions we need to follow in the group discussion and the presentation strategy? All this we are going to learn in this group, in this third module or third unit. And students, for third module, you have to refer the book that is Technical Communication. Please take down Technical Communication, Principle and Practice, second edition by Meenakshi Raman. Technical Communication Principles and Practice, second edition by Meenakshi Raman and Sangeeta Sharma. by Meenakshi Raman and Sangeeta Sharma. So what is communication, students? What is communication? What is communication?
Interactive, ma'am.
Interactive agala, interaction. We can say interaction. Yes. Any other answer? Interaction. Yes. Exchange of information. Correct. Communication is nothing but exchange. If we are not exchanging any information, then how it will become communication? See here. A is here, B is here. If A is telling some information to B, when B listen, when B listens, then he responds. He responds. Correct, no? He responds. Means they both are exchanging some information. They both are exchanging some information. If B is not accepting what or receiving, if B is not receiving what A is sending, will it become exchange of information? Will it become communication? Hey students, will it become communication? Ali, please respond. No, Arjun, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Ashok,
yes, ma'am.
Murli,
yes, ma'am.
Respond,
ma'am.
Madi.
Yes, ma'am.
Already this online class, it is like one-way communication. And whenever I ask some questions, at least that time you please respond, all of you. So do you agree with me? See, when here I am taking two persons, person A and person B, when person A is sending some message or talking something to person B, then when person B is not receiving, not accepting or not listening, what A is sending, will it become exchange of information?
When he listen,
only then he will respond. Correct, no? Only then we can say they are exchanging some information. So we can say that as a communication. We can say that as a communication. Again, there may be one to many communication. There may be one to many communication, and there may be many to many communication. Is it possible? No. So in a communication, what happens there? The exchange of information will takes place. There may be one to one communication in the beginning. In according to my PPT, this slide, so only two persons were there, A and B. Only two persons were exchanging the information. When a person A is telling hi to B, when he listens, only then he responds. After listening again, he may tell hello, had your lunch, had your breakfast. So like this, a casual conversation is happening. That is nothing but a communication. So they both are exchanging the information. So when communication means, it may be a one-to-one communication, one-to-many communication, or many-to-many communication. So here next we have group communication. Group communication. So as I told earlier, so communication may be one-to-one, one-to-many, one-to-one, one-to-many, and group communication implies many-to-many communication. Correct, no, students? Group communication implies many-to-many communication. There, many people are involved in the communication. So when it happens, where it happens? It happens in organizations, government offices, factories, and etc. So the communication, the group communication, so the group communication may not happen at home, because in home only two people may involved, only two people may be there in at home. So when you take example of any offices, government offices or factories or any organization, organization means it may education or institute may also come as a organization. There many people will be there. Organization means you can take example of software companies also or any other companies also. So in the organization, in government offices and in factories, many people will be there. So there a group communication will happen or the group communication may happen. So now here I'll mention one example of a software company. So what happens, a company has received a project, students assume, so the company has received the project. So what is, so once a company has received the project, first thing is they will decide the resources. They will decide the resources. What may be the resources? Yes, what may be the resources? Respond, the resources may be human resource. The resources may be human resource. Yes, correct, no? So here, I have a software company. So that company has received one project, from a client, or from a customer. The company has received a project from a client. So first step, what they do is the organization will decide the human resource. So they decide how many people should. So see, still it is not freezed. Still it is not blocked how many. So initially they may take 4 to 5 people. So what they tell them, what they tell to the those group of people, you go to the client and collect the requirements. Yes, will, is the company will do that?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, they collect the requirement. So in the requirement process, what happens? First, when they go to client, first they try to understand what is the objective of the client. So based on their objective only, the team will set their objective. And they collect the requirement from the clients. Why they collect the requirements? Because based on their requirements, the company has to develop the project. So what they do, so they go to the client. Hospital management and in software engineer, software testing also I gave the same example, students. So if they want to if the client want to want a software of hospital management, so the team will go to the client and they ask what type of software you need, what is your requirements, how in what way you want the project should run. So all these questions will be having the these persons will be having all these questions, and they will ask to the client, and the client may give the I want the registration form for the patient. Yes, students, are you understanding? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So they the registration of a form and the discharge summary, registration of a patient, discharge summary of the patient, and the treatment what you are giving. That will be maintained in the case sheet. if you see to collect the requirement, when you go to client, you cannot meet whoever you want. Why? Because all this information will be having already some hospital is there. I'll take hospital now, Chetana Hospital. All there, all the works or all the document is maintained manually. Initially, everything is maintained manually. Now they want to move to automation. They want to move it to automation. So they request some software company. They request some software company and they ask them to develop software for our hospital. So they put this request to the software company. Next, what happened? A team of some members will go and visit to the hospital. So there, when they go to Nava Chetana Hospital, they cannot meet a receptionist. They cannot meet a person who is working there. They have to meet the main owner of the Nava Chetana Hospital, because they will be knowing what all the requirements they have. Correct, no? They decide what are the requirements they need to implement in the software. So simply, blindly, we cannot go and we cannot ask to the receptionist, what is your requirement? To the owner or to the main person, we have to, the team has to meet and they have to take a requirement from the client. So here the owner of this Nava Chetana Hospital will become a client to this software company. Correct, no? So he is the client to this software company or customer to this software company. The team will receives the, or the team will collect the requirement from this person, from this owner. The owner will give the requirement. As the requirements, as I told, the registration of a patient, the discharge summary of the patient, or the case sheet of the patient. In case sheet, maybe for the outpatient, they don't check BP and sugar frequently. Maybe for the inpatient, every time they may check BP and sugar frequently. Now you may ask how this group communication is coming to picture. Yes, nobody is getting that out. Yes. Here in Nava Chetana, we cannot say a single person will be there, because there also they will be having a group of people. Only a single person cannot decide what are the requirements. There a group of people will be there from the organization, from software company also. A group of people went to ask the requirement. There they are discussing about the software. So there also the group communication is happening. So once they take a requirement, then they do planning. How to develop the project based on the requirement and based on the cost. By listening all the requirements, the company will tell some cost. The company will tell some amount to the organization that this much amount we need to develop your project. Maybe this hospital is not able to pay so much of amount, then they may go for a negotiation. I may not be able to pay, so you do some, you give some discount, so like that, those types of conversation will happen. So that is also we can say as a example of group communication. And the members of an organization may communicate in group to achieve any of the following purpose. So the members are there in the group communication. They are going to achieve the following purposes. What are the following purposes? Share and exchange information and ideas. Yes, when group discussion happens, then there what happens? The sharing and exchanging of information will take place. And collect information or feedback of any project, policy or scheme. See, if you take example of any organization, if any policy they want to implement, a single person will not take that decision. If you if we take example of our department only, if Saturday afternoon we want to conduct a lab, if Saturday afternoon we want to conduct a lab, then only one person will not take a decision. One person will not take a decision. That person may be the lab in charge or the faculty who is handling the lab. Only the single person cannot take a decision. First, the message should be communicated to head of the department. Message should be communicated to head of the department. Then head of the department will know the availability of the staff and availability of the resources, whether the labs will be free that time, whether the all faculties will be available that time. So they have to see all this, no? So here also some communication is happening. Yes, when this faculty go and approach to head of the department stating that today, Saturday afternoon, I want to conduct a lab session. So this person is sharing information with head of the department, and the head of the department may know that today after Saturday afternoon placement is happening in our department, in our department lab. So what he tells is, no, it is not possible that because already placement schedule has put placement is going to happen in placement will be there after Saturday afternoon. Then so you see, when these two exchange this information, then what happens? They will come to one decision. Correct, no? They'll come to one decision. What decision? Yes, this Saturday I cannot conduct. This person will come to this person will decide that this Saturday I cannot conduct an extra lab. Why? Because the lab is not free. See, when he only takes the decision, then it may be problem to the students. Why? Because students will think that today or Saturday afternoon I have lab, so they come and they sit in the lab. But when before informing to the students, when this person talk to head of the department, there by exchanging their information, it will be helpful for them to take a decision. Is it right, students? Yes. And collect information or feedback for any policies. So to implement any policy also, we have to collect the information and take or sometimes we have to take a feedback also. Any example for this? Anybody can give? Yes. Yes, students. From I think Friday you received a mail from the principal that from Saturday, 1 week, you will be having a online class. Correct, no? Online class. So here, this is one policy. See, this scheme is taken by BMSIT College. This policy is implemented in BMSIT College, that is from 27 March to April 3rd, we are going to conduct online class. See, to take this decision, only principal will not take this decision. The principal will call the head of the department of all the department, heads of all the department. He takes a feedback. He collects the information. Why the online class are happening now? Why the online classes are happening now, students? No reason?
Cases
are increasing. The COVID cases are increasing. So we don't want to, the organization don't want to take any risk with the students, so that's why the class again we are starting a online classes. That is not till the completion of the semester, only for this date, only from March 27th to 3rd April. So how we implemented this policy, students? How the college has implemented the policy? The college has collected the information about this COVID, and the college has taken some feedback from some person. So based on that, they have taken this, they have implemented the, they have implemented this policy. So only one person will not be able to take any decision. So after taking a, after collecting the information, after taking the feedback, so what they do, they arrive to one decision that from this date to this date, if we conduct a online class, maybe after 1 week the cases may reduce. Again, we can come back to offline classes. So it will be helpful to arrive at a decision on important issues. Solve a problem concerning the organization as a whole. So by this, we it will be helpful for to solve the problem related to the organization. Yes, students, understood? Next, we have forms of group discussion. Forms of group discussion. Yes, students, can you see? Can you see the slide? Is the slide is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here, so I'll not show it in the slideshow because here I want to write it here. So that's why I'm not showing in a slideshow. The font is visible. Yes, students, the font is visible. So here, the forms of group communication, name, purpose or objective, structure of group, characteristics of group and procedure. See, the first example is meeting. See, meeting means there will be more number of people, 4 to 5 people will be there. Correct, no? Meeting means the number of people will be more. What is the purpose of the meeting? What is the objective of the meeting? Yes, students, what is the objective of the meeting?
To discuss more.
To discuss. To convey information to a group of people. Is it right? See, when a decision, when principal has taken a decision to conduct online class from 27th March to 3rd April, then HOD, what the head of the department will do, the head of the department will call a meeting. Correct, no? Because he cannot go to the head of the department, he or she cannot go to each faculty member to tell that from 27th March to 4th April we have online class. Correct, no? So they call for the meeting. They call for the meeting and they discuss about this. And that head of the department will convey this message to a group of people. So the example of a group communication is meeting. Meeting as a meeting here I have taken the example. The purpose of the meeting is to convey information to group of people. And only to convey the information. The purpose of meeting is only to convey the convey the message, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Only that. Make decision. Yes. Solve problem. These are the objective of the meeting or purpose of the meeting. And what is the structure of a meeting? Two or more. Yes, students, understanding is correct, no? In the meeting, there may be two or more person. The structure of the meeting is two or more, or hundreds of people. Yes. there may be no there may be hundreds of people also. And when I say meeting, this will be a formal physical sitting setting. So the structure of a meeting is in meeting, two or more persons are involved, or two or more people will be involved, or sometimes hundreds of people will also be there. And the structure of the meeting is a physical setup should be there. A physical setting will be there. The structure, the characteristics of the meeting. What may be the characteristics, students? You know, meeting alone here at the HOD also conducted so many meetings, no? To all the students, with all the students, HOD has conducted so many meetings. So what may be the characteristics of the meeting? Punctuality. Correct? So when I say 10 o'clock, I'm starting the meeting. All of you should join to the meeting before 10 o'clock or exactly at 10 o'clock. You don't join the meeting after 5 minutes or after 10 minutes. So be punctual. The meeting will be presided by the chairman. So to that meeting, one head will be there. One head will be there. That head will be a chairman of the meeting. And that meeting will start with an introduction. Yes, students, are you following? Are you understanding the example of this meeting? How the communication is happening? What is the purpose and what is the structure? What are the characteristics of this meeting? Yes, following.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So punctuality. And presided by a chairman, and the meeting should start with an introduction. And Ashtena, any other characteristics of meeting? And the meeting should be information centered. When a person is called for the meeting, we have to talk on the agenda. We have to talk on the topic. We have to talk on the purpose why the meeting has called. Simply, I cannot say that tomorrow I want to apply leave. Tomorrow I don't have class. Tomorrow I am planning to go out. Tomorrow I am planning to go out of station. So like that, I should not talk, no? So as a chairman of the meeting, I have to talk based on the information. So based on the agenda, why I have called the meeting. Simply, I cannot talk whatever I want. So the meeting should be information centered. And any other time. Answer?
Time.
Yes. So when we call for the meeting, then it should not prolong hours together. The time limit should be there. And when we are giving a chance to talk each person in the meeting, then we have to give fair enough chance to everyone. So only for experienced people I'll give time, or only for freshers I'll give time. There should not be like that. Each person should get a equal chance to talk. Maybe periodic. So for to each, what is periodic? Round robin algorithm. So we may have to decide in the meeting how many people are there. To each person a equal time should be given. To each person 1 minute time or 2 minutes time, whatever. There should not be any partiality in the meeting. And no side conversation. No side conversation. So when a meeting is happening, then we should concentrate in the meeting. In the beginning of the class, I told no, in the listening ability, side conversation should be avoided. Talking with your neighbors, talking with your friends, or seeing phones. So that should be avoided. Side conversation should not be there. You have to concentrate in the meeting on the agenda or on the topic. Yes, any other? Next, the procedure. What is the procedure to conduct a meeting?
Yes, read now.
Yes.
Greeting.
Yes, and greeting is here. Okay. Greeting will come in the characteristics only. The characteristic of a, because here I have mentioned, no? Start with an introduction. What is the procedure to conduct a meeting? A prior notice should be given. A prior notice should be given. Simply, suddenly, 9:55, we should not say 10 o'clock you have a meeting. A prior notice should be given. And in the notice, we have to put the agenda prepared. So, what is the agenda? Why? Agenda means what? What is the topic or what is the reason for today's meeting? What is the reason for today's meeting? So when we call for the meeting, a prior notice should be given to the members who will attend the meeting. And a agenda should be prepared and it should be informed to the members who will attend the meeting. And this is very important. That is, minutes should be recorded. What is the meaning of minutes should be recorded? Hey, students, what is the meaning of minutes should be recorded? Means whatever we are talking or whatever we are discussing in the meeting, that should be recorded. That should be the conversation. Any points, if some other faculty is telling some points, that everything should be recorded. Everything should be recorded. Why should be recorded? Why meeting should be recorded? Because of some emergency work or because of some other work. Maybe I'm also part of the meeting, but I have class at that time. It will not be possible for me to attend the meeting. Then those who are involved in the meeting, if they record the minutes, and if they or if they write down what are the things have has discussed in the meeting, and they have they will send to us. When they send to us, then even we will come to know what has happened in the meeting. Correct, no? Even we will come to know what has I because of class I have not attended the meeting. So once I received the minutes of meeting, then I'll also understand what is happening, what was the agenda for the meeting, and for this agenda, what decision they have taken. So that will be what decision that will be that person who has not attended the meeting, that person will also come to know what decision has taken and what purpose and what has happened in the meeting, that will come to know. So the meeting or records of the meeting is very much important. So next is seminar. So meeting understood, students, how the meeting will happen? Artha aita? What is the purpose of the seminar? Purpose of the seminar? Share knowledge. Is it the purpose of the knowledge? Share knowledge. Yes. And the structure of the meeting will be, it may be small group or a large group. Maybe small group or larger group. The characteristics of meeting is it will be a closed interaction. The characteristic of meeting is it will be a closed interaction, and it happens in academic nature. So we cannot say that the seminar will happen only in academic institute. The seminar will happen in software companies also, but it happens in a academic nature. The seminar is nothing but it is a closed interaction. So a group of people will be there. Within those group of people, the interaction will happen there. The exchange of information will take place, and it will be a free discussion. And the procedure of the seminar is here the presentation of the topic will happen. And you can take example of conference, group discussion. So those things we'll see in the next class, students. Yes, students, understood this? Any doubt here? Group communication and forms of group communication?
No, ma'am.
Stop here. Next examples we'll see in the next class. Yes, students, here what all the points I have mentioned, no, here you also think that whether these points are valid points or not. Yes, you also decide the purpose of the meeting, in the forms of group communication. I have taken example as meeting and seminar. Meeting, the purpose of the meeting, conveying information,
convey information to a group of people, and it is the objective of the meeting is to make decision and to solve the problem. How the structure of the meeting, the structure of in the meeting, there may be two people or more people, or there may be hundreds of people also, and the meeting will happen in the physical setting. The physical, wherever we stand, there will not start meeting. There a specific place will be there for meeting. There in a systematic manner we conduct a meeting. The characteristics of the meeting, that is punctuality, and this should be preceded by a chairman. Start with an introduction, information center. It should be information centered, and the conversation should not happen with others in the meeting. So we have to follow the timings in the meeting, and equal priority, equal preference should be given in the meeting. And the procedure for the meeting is a briefer prior notice should be given, the agenda should be prepared, and the minutes of meeting should be recorded. These things are there. Hey students, answer your attendance. Asta?
Present, ma'am.
Asta, why you did not attend so many classes, physical classes? Where are you?
Ma'am, actually I'm not in Bangalore. I've informed my proctor about it.
Okay, I know that, but when you are planning to come back to Bangalore? Because only these 3 days we have online classes. Again, the offline classes will start, no?
Yes, ma'am. From Thursday, I will be in the college only, ma'am.
Okay. Abhinav?
Present, ma'am.
Last class absent. Aishwarya?
Present, ma'am.
Ambrish?
Yes, ma'am.
Anu?
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
My last class absent. Arjun?
Present, ma'am.
Benita?
Ashok, present, ma'am.
Ashok?
Present, ma'am.
Bhargavi? Bhargavi? Bhavisha?
Present, ma'am.
Chaitra?
Present, ma'am.
Dev?
Present, ma'am.
Last class absent. Deeksha? Okay,
present, ma'am.
Deepika L?
Present, ma'am.
Deepika M?
Present, ma'am.
Murli?
Present, ma'am.
Gangubai?
Present, ma'am.
Harshit?
Present, ma'am.
Last class ekappa bandilla? Junjar?
Miss Bandi there.
Harshit was there, Gudiya was not there last class, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Gudiya, today she's there, Gudiya?
No, Gudiya. Ma'am.
She's absent.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Junjar?
Present, ma'am.
Kavya?
Present, ma'am.
Kishore?
Present, ma'am.
Lata?
Yes, ma'am.
Manisha?
Present, ma'am.
Manjunath?
Yes, ma'am.
Nayana?
Yes, ma'am.
Neelanjan?
Yes, ma'am.
Why, sir, last two classes absent? Nishant? Nishant? Pavitra?
Present, ma'am.
Maithili? Maithili? Priyanka? Pavan?
Present, ma'am.
Akash?
Ma'am, present. Nishant, present, ma'am.
Ma'am, Akash, present.
Pavan is there, no? Akash?
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Rajeshwari?
Yes, ma'am.
Rakesh? Rakesh. Yeah.
Ma'am, Vaishnavi present, ma'am.
Wait, Vaishnavi, still I have not come to you. I think now you joined. Rashmi?
No, no, ma'am.
Present, ma'am. Kitchen, ma'am,
okay. Ravi?
Yes, ma'am.
Last class absent. Rizwan?
Present, ma'am.
Yakappa? Last class Pandila. Vishal?
Present, ma'am.
Savita?
Yes, ma'am.
Shruti?
Present, ma'am.
Sneha? Sneha? Spurti?
Present, ma'am.
Trinidhi?
Present, ma'am.
Srinivas?
Present, ma'am.
Saturday absent. Sunil? Vaishnavi?
Ma'am, Sunil present.
Present, ma'am. Present.
Winnie?
Present, ma'am.
Ma'am, Bhargavi present, ma'am.
With attendance hobekadre answer madilla andre absent and already absent mark madidinamma.
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಇದೆ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಕಟ್ ಕಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ಅವಾಗಿಂದ
ಓಕೆ ಸರಿ ಓಕೆ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
ನಿಶಾಂತ್
ಹಾ
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ನಿಶಾಂತ್
ರಮ್ಯಾ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
ಓಕೆ
ಮೈಥಿಲಿ
ಮೈಥಿಲಿ ವೈ ಯು ಡಿಡ್ನ್ಟ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾಂಡ್
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಗಾಟ್
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
ಪ್ರಿಯಾಂಕಾ ವೇಟ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಚೆಕ್
I'm Priyanka.
Wait. I'll come. Gudiya? Gudiya is not there, no? Gudiya? Priyanka, you are there, huh?
I'm Priyanka present. Okay.
Rajeshwari?
Yes, ma'am, present.
ಮತ್ತೆ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ಆಬ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದೀನಿ
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ನಾನು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದೆ
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಸ್ನೇಹಾ
ಎಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
ಓಕೆ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಸಿ ಯು ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್